In this video, we're going to integrate Lutron Ratu Select with Control 4. I will cover the basic step on how to make those two systems work together. And by the end of this tutorial, we should be able to make a Control 4 device talk to a Ratu Select equipment, as well as to make a Ratu Select device talk to a Control 4 equipment. This tutorial should be useful for any AV technician or programmer, or for anyone that would like to see how easy it is to set this up. So without further ado, let's do it. Hi, I'm Xavier, and welcome to the Adelux YouTube channel for lighting control and home automation tutorials. If you're also into this, please consider to like and subscribe to my channel so you can be updated when a new video is released. So let's just dive into it. To illustrate all the programming steps, I've set up a small Ratu Select demo. I have a Ratu Select main repeater, a couple of Lutron inline dimmers controlling their respective table lamps, a Pico remote for each of those table lamps, a PicoSync keypad, as well as a battery-operated Lutron wireless blind. I also have a full Smart Home Control 4 system running the latest OS 3.1 as of the time of this recording. This Control 4 system controls some of my lighting, audio and video equipment, as well as my CCTV, intercom system, etc., etc. I also need to mention that all this equipment has been programmed and sit on the same Ethernet network. The very first thing I have to do is to fully program my Lutron Ratu Select system, which means to have all my Lutron equipment fully set up using the Lutron Ratu Select app. I've completed this step already, and if you want to know how I've done this initial setup, I've posted a basic step-by-step guide, and you can find the link on the description below or by clicking on the card above. Now, let's have a quick look at my Ratu Select app. I have my two table lamps, one called black table lamp and the other one white table lamp, as well as their respective Pico remote, one called Pico black table lamp and the other one Pico white table lamp. My Lutron wireless blind has also been set up, as well as the Pico remote that operates it. I also have my PicoSync keypad, and under the scene tab, I've also set up a couple of scenes, one called movie scene and the other one called living room off, which includes a mixture of lighting levels and blind position. The objective now is to export this Lutron information to my Control 4 system. To do so, from the Lutron app, I go to Settings, select Advanced, then select Integration, and then click on Send Integration Report. From here, the Lutron app prepares an email to send. That email contains all the integration IDs of all the Lutron equipment and other objects that can be integrated to a third-party control system, such as Control 4 in our case. So let me first send that email to myself.
So what is an integration ID? An integration ID is a simple number generated automatically by the Lutron system. Each Lutron equipment has its own integration ID assigned to it. That ID number will help me setting up Control 4 to operate as well as to listen to my Ratu Select system. So let's have a closer look at this integration report.
To start, we have a list of devices, and the first device is the Smart Bridge 2, which refers to the Ratu Select main repeater, which also use the integration ID number 1. What we also need to know is that main repeater offer access to 100 system scenes, and we can find amongst those 100 scenes listed here my movie and my living room off scene, but also scenes called arriving home and leaving home, which are scenes that are set up by default to use with the geofencing feature. Then, scrolling down the list, I'll find the other Lutron devices, such as my Picos, my inline dimmers, and my motorized blind. And as we notice here, each of those Lutron equipment has its own integration ID. We will understand more about IDs in a minute, so now let me launch the Control 4 software called Composer Pro.
To make this work, on the Control 4 software, we will have to first add the relevant Lutron Ratu Select drivers, then make the connections of the Lutron equipment within Control 4 Composer, and to finish, do the programming so the two systems can talk to each other. So let's start with adding the Lutron drivers. Under System Design, on the bottom left corner, I'll use the Search tab here on the right-hand side and type in Lutron RAW to select, followed by Enter, with my local and online options ticked. And below, I'll find now a list of available Lutron RAW to select drivers. The first driver I'll have to add is the Lutron RAW to select repeater driver. To do so, I select the room it needs to go in, and in our case here today, I'm going to select the living room, and then I double-click on the repeater driver. Once this is done, I'll add the other drivers that match my RAW to select setup. So first, I'll add the drivers for my inline dimmers using the Lutron RAW to select dimmer driver, and I need one for my black table lamp and another one for my white table lamp. Next, I'll add the driver for my Lutron motorized blind using the Lutron RAW to select shade driver and name it Sheer Blind. Then I'll add my picos using the Lutron RAW to select pico driver. So I've got one for my black table lamp and another one for my white table lamp. I've got one to operate my shear blind, and I also have a PicoSync keypad that uses the same driver. It doesn't really matter in which order you add the Lutron drivers. The most important is that you add the driver for the RAW to select main repeater first. I will also invite you to read through the documentation for each driver here, as it will give you a good overall understanding of the Lutron RAW to select integration process. So, once I'm done with the Lutron drivers, I'll move on to connections. Now, the objective in connection is to associate each Lutron device with the correct integration ID that has been provided earlier from our Lutron RAW to select app. So let's pull back that list. Let's leave the main repeater ID for the moment and go to the next device, which in my case is the Pico for the blind in the living room called Pico Blind, and its integration ID is 5. So in Composer, I'm going to select my Pico Blind. Then once selected, I'm going to select its control input connection on the right hand side. And as soon as it is selected, all my Lutron integration ID for my RAW to select repeater appear on the bottom screen. And at this point, I'm just going to drag that Pico connection to ID number 5. There we go. Then I'm going to do exactly the same thing for all the other Lutron devices using my list of integration IDs. As previously mentioned, the order in that list doesn't really matter, as those IDs are simply there to identify our devices. They're like a name that both control systems will use to talk to one another. So next, I'll make the connection for my white table lamp Pico using ID number 10. My black table lamp Pico is using ID number 11. And the PicoSync keypad, ID number 12. My lights and shades are identified as zones within the RAW to select system, but the principle is still the same within the Control 4 Composer software. So my living room blind uses ID number 2. The inline dimmer that controls the white table lamp uses ID number 8. And the black table lamp, ID number 9. Once I'm done with my connections, I can start programming my equipment. So let's select the Programming tab on the bottom left here. In programming, you will enjoy a large array of possibilities when it comes to integrating Lutron RAW to select with Control 4. Here, I'm just going to show you some very basic programming examples so we can just understand the principles. I believe that the most basic, but also most exciting thing to see is that as soon as we've added and connected our Lutron devices, they've become available from our Control 4 navigators. So if I'm taking my Control 4 tabletop touchscreen, for example, and select my living room, under lights, I'll find my black and white table lamp dimmers. From there, I can turn on and switch off. Each of those lighting circuits
as well as dim them, as I'm doing here, on a black table lamp. And I can also open, close, and adjust my Lutron shade. In the living room, I have a Control 4 keypad where the bottom button is a room off button, which means that it turns off all the audio and video equipment in that room. So if I need that button to also switch off the light and close the Lutron blind, I can program it to do so. Let's see how to do it. Under programming, I'm going to find and select that button on the left hand side of the screen. So here, I select the all off button and the press event. Then from here, I can do two things. First, I can go and find on the right hand side of the screen my Lutron dimmers, like I'm doing here on the black table lamp, and select the command to switch it off, and then add it to my programming script, like I'm doing here. And obviously, do the same thing for the white table lamp, as well as select my motorized blind and set it to close, like I'm showing here. An alternative way to do this is to, instead of selecting and set each individual Lutron equipment, I can instead use a scene that I have previously set up within my Lutron RatoSelect system. To do so, let me first delete my previous programming and instead go to my RatoSelect repeater and select it. Then, on the action screen below, I select device specific command, which will allow me to activate a scene. Do you remember? A scene! These are the scenes at the beginning of my Lutron integration report. And there, I have my living room of scene that is not using an ID, but a number. Number 4. And that's the number I need to use in my Control 4 program, so I'll specify the scene number 4 here and add it to my programming script. Now that this scene has been added, let me test it. So I'll press on my room off button and I have all the EV equipment switching off, as well as my Lutron light switching off and my Lutron blind closing, all from one single press, which is great. Now let's program a Lutron PicoSync keypad to talk to Control 4. In the living room, I have a Sonos speaker as part of my Control 4 setup. This could have been a TV or any other audio or video equipment controlled via Control 4. So let's say that when I use my PicoSync keypad to trigger my relax scene here, I would like it also to play some music in the living room. To do so, I first select my PicoSync keypad, then select the appropriate button for my relax scene. And to know which one to use, I need to go back to the system design screen, and within the documentation tab of my PicoSync keypad, I can find the information on which button to use. My PicoSync keypad has 4 buttons, and the relax scene is the 3rd one down, so I'll be using button number 9 as I'm showing here. Now, knowing this, I go back to my programming screen, then select button 9 press in the event list for my Pico. Next, I look for my living room Sonos driver here and select the appropriate action, such as play or select a favorite radio station to play, like I'm doing here. Now, let's test it. As you can see, when I press on my relax scene, my table lamps that are controlled via my Lutron inline dimmers went to the relax scene setting, as well as my Lutron shade. And at the same time, my Sonos started playing some nice, relaxing tunes. Voila, there you have it. We've just integrated a Lutron RatoSelect system with Control 4. First, on a fully programmed RatoSelect system, we generated the Lutron RatoSelect integration report. Then, we used that report to set up the Lutron devices within the Control 4 software and done some basic programming examples to understand the principles. If you found this tutorial useful, or if you enjoyed a little bit of tech talk with a pinch of French accent, please consider to like and subscribe. If there is any specific feature you would like me to cover in the future, please let me know in the comment section below. Thank you very much, and talk to you again on the next tutorial.